Yeah, and I find it so interesting, right? Because you have your background in education, you're a teacher. And how did that background kind of prime you for the role that you play now in the Bitcoin space?
Well, I suppose it didn't really. Part of what drew me towards teaching, I suppose, because I worked specifically with kids who had behavioral issues. And maybe the thing which pulled me towards that, you see a bunch of people who are kind of disenfranchised and they don't really click or vibe with society and they sort of lose their place in society. And you see there's a lot of wasted potential, which just really ends up just being wasted away. And it's always very frustrating. I think that's a similar worldview to that of a Bitcoiner, which kind of sees a lot of wasted potential, which is being stifled by a very clunky legacy financial system, which again, as we spoke off air, if you change the underlying value transfer mechanism, then the whole architecture of society could change. Just as if you changed, the internet from being based on advertising revenue to being based on more of a model like your podcasting 2.0, it changes the very architecture of the internet. And so I think maybe that's maybe how it had some impact, is that it is a similar want to try and help people be more empowered and have more autonomy and be less disenfranchised, through giving them better tool set, I suppose.